which worship this morning at First United Methodist Church of Coxsackie. And my name is Pastor Lee. And welcome everyone who's attending this service through online too. So do we have an announcement this morning?
I do. I just, good morning, want to let everyone know, back in January, at the Ad Council meeting, we had discussed doing a little random act of kindness, so to speak, for all of the staff at the schools because of everything. You know, COVID at that time was just going crazy again, and kids had gone back to school, and everybody was just kind of at wit's end. Anyhow, we followed through, finally, and the worship committee got together, and for those that can see, the cross may be in the way for some, but what we did is we had some four little the Lindt chocolates and put in there, thank you for your dedication and perseverance. And we said, from the First United Methodist Church of Coxsackie. And that was it. Random act of kindness, no strings attached, sort of thing. And it was so well received with folks. And I believe Pastor Lee even got an email from one of the teachers expressing the gratitude, and, which I didn't think about, but she felt how appropriate it was during Holy Week that they received this. So that was from all of us. So if you're going down the street and somebody says thanks, now you know what it's all about, right?
Thank you for coming. And do you have any other announcements, Tanya? So we are reminded that this is the day that the Lord has made. So we gather together and worship the Lord. This time I invite you to stand, so that we might join together in our call to worship, which is responsive. Welcome today. Look, where our Lenten journey has brought us.
We walk to the shore of the hills of Jesus. We rest. to the upper room and endured our own sorrows. We stood at the cross and made the room out of our fear.
Now we are here in the splendor and beauty of this place.
Everything for first in the life. Jesus is alive. He is risen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And today's opening hymn is Christ alone is risen today. In our hymnal number 302. Thank you. Now let's join our hearts and our spirit of compassion. We have to admit it,
O Lord, that we had our doubts. We have heard the resurrection story, and for so many years it has remained just a nice story. But this time it is different. This time we have walked the path with Christ. We have journeyed through the wilderness and valleys, to the mountaintops, to the courtyard, the garden, and the cross. Now we bring us to the empty tomb, and to the joyous news of the truth of Christ. Forgive us when we so easily doubt the truth of his resurrection. Forgive us when we feel that we have to have absolute proof of everything. Your love in Jesus Christ is all our proof we need. You conquered death and sin. You brought us to new life. We praise your holy name and sing our unending song of hope and thanksgiving. Christ is the Lord, risen from the dead. Hallelujah. Amen.
Well, let us continue our silent prayers this morning. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Know beyond all doubt that God's love is always with you, surrounding you, believing you, comforting you. Be at peace. Amen.
Amen.
Well, let us pray together the prayer that Jesus has told us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
And as we continue, please join us to pray for illumination.
Lord, open our hearts and minds by the power of your Holy Spirit, that as the scriptures are read and your word are proclaimed, we may hear with joy what you say to us today. Amen. While they are yet speaking, I hear. The wolf and the lamb shall
are like the ox, but the serpent, its food shall be dust. They shall not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, says the Lord. In the gospel reading, stand if you can, please, is John chapter 20, verses 1 to 18. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." And Peter and the other disciples set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came following him and went to the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple who reached the tomb first also went in, and he saw and believed, for as yet they did not understand the scripture that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white, sitting there where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know it was Jesus. And Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." And Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabuni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and she told them that he had said these things to her. This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Can you sit?
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
Christ the Lord is risen today.
Amen. Amen.
So when there was still darkness in this world, Jesus Christ broke the darkness and raised from the dead. So we gather today and celebrate this morning when the sun comes up, when the sunlight shines all over the places. We remind Jesus Christ's resurrection. And when we see this cross with the beautiful flowers, we remind Jesus' invitation to eternal life. This cross is no longer a symbol of shame or suffering, but it is the glory of Jesus Christ and his victory over his death. Amen.
Amen.
Early in the morning, on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. You know, the stone that covered Jesus' tomb was so heavy. At least two men were needed to roll away and move this stone. So when Mary saw this stone was moved, she was afraid because she thought something bad had happened. She might think robbers or people who were against Jesus had taken Jesus' path. So she ran when the Peter said, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Someone took Jesus' body, out of the tomb. What a shocking news. So Peter and other disciples ran back to the tomb. They had fear and anxiety that they couldn't even keep the body of Jesus from others. And when Peter arrived, ran into the tomb, he saw the linen wrappings right there. And the cloth that had been on Jesus' back, now lying with the linen wrappings, a rolled up in a place by itself. However, when Peter and other disciples see this, they couldn't understand what was happening. They couldn't remember Jesus' word that he will rise again from the dead. Matthew chapter 16, verse 21. Jesus already told to his disciples about his death and resurrection. From that time on, Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and undergo great suffering at the hands of the elders and chief priests and scribes, and be killed. And on the third day, he raised. However, Peter didn't understand this Jesus' word and still did not know what happened at the tomb. So they just returned to their homes. They ran and came to the tomb and tried to figure out what had happened to Jesus' body. But they couldn't know it. They couldn't remember Jesus' word and understand. And they left the tomb without knowing nothing. However, Mary was still there outside of the tomb, and she was weeping. Now she was deeply sad because she couldn't do nothing to find Jesus' body. She didn't know what to do. And she bent over to look into the tomb, to check. She didn't go into the tomb. So when she looked into the tomb, she saw two angels in white, sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying. One at head and the other at feet. It is an interesting point that when another disciple who came with Peter looked into the tomb, he only saw the linen wrappings lying there. But this time, Mary saw angels sitting there. And they said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" So Mary said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." And when she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there. She noticed that someone was near at the tomb. But she didn't know that it was Jesus. And now Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" But Mary was supposing him to be the gardener. And she said to Jesus, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him. I will take him away." Mary is asking Jesus, "Sir, if you took the body of Jesus, please tell me where you have laid him. I am looking for him. I should find him. He is my teacher, my Lord." Mary came to the tomb to see the dead Jesus' body. Mary was afraid. And she found out Jesus' body was not there. And Peter and the other disciples also came to check and see what had happened in Jesus' tomb. However, they couldn't understand what had happened. They couldn't remember Jesus' word. And now Mary was in deep sorrow because Jesus' body was taken away from the tomb. She was seized with her sorrow, fear, and anxiety, and they made her not recognize Jesus. When she saw Jesus, she couldn't recognize him. When she heard Jesus' voice, she couldn't recognize his voice. Mary followed Jesus for about 3 years. She accompanied Jesus and saw his miracles and his ministry, and listened to his sermons. And how could she not have recognized his face and voice? However, Jesus sent her again, Mary. Then she turned, said to him in Hebrew, Rabbi, which means teacher. When Jesus called her by name, Mary could recognize his voice and answer him. Mary didn't expect to meet resurrected Jesus at the tomb. She couldn't imagine. Her sorrow and fear covered her eyes and ears. She wasn't able to recognize Jesus. And Peter came to the tomb and saw the cloth and linen, but he couldn't understand what that means. Peter couldn't understand Jesus' teaching and his word about his death and resurrection. When two of Jesus' disciples met Jesus on the way to Emmaus, they couldn't recognize him. They were having a conversation with Jesus. They were talking about the empty tomb and Jesus' resurrection. However, they couldn't recognize Jesus, who was walking with them. And when resurrected Jesus appeared to the disciples who were fishing, they couldn't recognize him. However, when Jesus called Mary by name, Mary could recognize Jesus. When Jesus broke the bread, blessed, broke it, and gave it to two of his disciples, they could recognize him. When Jesus said to his disciples, who couldn't catch anything all night, cast a net to the right side of the boat, then they could recognize Jesus. When Mary and other disciples were in darkness and couldn't see anything, Jesus came to them and shone upon them and let them see Jesus again. So what does this Easter mean to you? Are you able to see Jesus? Are you able to listen to his voice? Can you understand his resurrection? Or are you still in darkness? When the morning comes, are we caught up in darkness and unable to see the light? Our sorrows, fears, sadness, and anxiety may keep us from seeing the light, but keep us in darkness. Resurrected Jesus is standing next to us, but we may not see him. We may not recognize him because of our darkness. And I'd like to ask you, what is holding you today? Are you still in darkness? Are you still weeping? Today is the day of joy. Jesus Christ has been raised from the dead. So can you rejoice today? Are you very happy because of the resurrection? Or does something still hold you and make you sad or worried? But today, please remember that Jesus Christ, who was raised from the dead, comes to you. He is standing next to you and calls you by your name.
Amen.
And ask you, why are you weeping? Why are you still in darkness? Come out there. Come to me. Come to the light. I am the light of the world. I am shining upon you and all over the world. And I bring peace to you. So come to me and don't cry. So Jesus is coming to us when we are sad, when we are going through a hard time, when we are tired and frustrated. Jesus comes to us and calls us He opens our eyes and ears and lets us see him, listen to his voice. So this time I invite you to open your heart and mind and listen to Jesus' voice. Put down everything that holds your mind today. Empty yourself and humbly listen to Jesus. This is a blessing, right, for Israel. We'll do Israel Monday after the service. So when we have a soup Sunday, we put chocolate and candy inside this plastic egg. But this plastic egg should be empty to place chocolate in it. If there's something inside this egg, we have to empty it first. So what does Jesus' empty tomb mean to us? I believe we should empty ourselves to fully accept Jesus Christ. We should empty the things that fill our heart first. Then we can fill our lives with Jesus Christ, then we can clearly see, listen, and understand his resurrection. His resurrection is not the end, but the beginning of a new life. It is not a one-time event, but it is an invitation to a new life in this world. Jesus' resurrection invites us to a new life, the living with Jesus every day and forever.
Amen.
It is a life that keeps emptying our lives, ourselves, but filling us with the grace of God. It is a life with Jesus Christ, and it is a journey of walking with Jesus. So Easter is a day to remind Jesus' invitation to eternal life and decide to follow his journey in this world. And do you know what Sunday do people go to church the most of the year?
Easter?
Right. You can see. So Easter is the highest attended day, Sunday. But do you know what the lowest attended Sunday of the year is? Is the first Sunday after Easter. I'm not talking about church attendance rate, but I'm questioning you and myself about how we can start a new life with Jesus Christ after Easter Sunday. And I encourage you to remember Jesus' resurrection in your daily life and live with his command. He said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always, to the end of the age." So there is a new life for the Easter people. And I hope to start this new journey with you together. Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
Let us pray. We'll give thanks to you. For you are good, and your steadfast love endures forever. O God, you sent us your only Son, Jesus Christ, and saved us from his suffering and death on the cross. By his death and resurrection, we can be saved and start a new journey in this world. Let us come out of our darkness in whatever day.
Let us see Jesus and listen to his voice. Let us empty ourselves and fill us with your grace. Please guide us, lead us, when we start this new journey together. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
This time, I invite you to stand on it. So as we sing our next hymn, Thine Be the Glory, the hymnal number 308.
Mother's boyfriend, Doug.
Oh, is it, you know, having sort of a...
carpal tunnel.
Luckily, just bruises on the left side and on her hand, so she is doing that. and Sunday. There's a joint. I was there this morning when we met over at McQuaid Park. The sun came up, freezing. But the sun did penetrate, and it felt good. And that's how Jesus is. He penetrates, and he feels good. And I want to share that with y'all. Praise God. And thank you, Jesus, for all you've done.
And it's sad that I missed the last week of the church services, but it was a joy that I was on vacation with my son in Florida, and my daughter came with me, and we had a lot of fun, and it was just very enjoyable to be with both of my kids for a full week.
Yes. Especially when you're fully
there. Yeah, it was a lot warmer there than it was here. It was a strange awakening when I got home last night.
I would like to take this opportunity to thank Pastor Lee and all the readers who led us through the daily devotions. Mm. Every day there was a different message with lots to think about, and I think this made Lent so meaningful for all of us. So thank you.
Thank you for all your participation, for reading and for reflection. Yeah, really, that's a great journey of that to this Easter Sunday. Thank you all.
Thank you for your gift.
So any other prayer, request, or personal service? And please keep praying for our prayer list and pray for the peace in Ukraine. Let's keep praying for the people who are suffering from this war and violence. And there are prayer lists, so please keep praying for those who need our prayers. Let us pray.
How magnificent this place is today. The flowers, the grace of our roasting area, shout the good news of your life. Their colors and shapes dance with joy at the news of resurrection of Jesus Christ. And we also rise in hope and celebration at this good news. The journey has been long. It does not end here. But rather, we are given new marching orders to go forth in confidence for God, to witness to the good news of the resurrection and the power of God's love in Jesus Christ. We are called to be bearers of the light and hope to areas in which darkness still stands. Keep us open to the needs and hurts of our people. Help us not to be so quick to condemn as we are to love. And help us to reach out in kindness and compassion whenever and wherever we can for healing. And remind us again the many ways in which you have and continue to bless our lives. For we ask these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And we will need a hymnal for the liturgy for the communion this morning. And you'll find our communion liturgy on page 9 in front. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you. Father, from heaven, creator of heaven and earth, you formed us in your image.
and breathe into the breath of life. When it turned away, the world failed. The world remained steadfast. You deliver us from captivity. Made a covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through the prophet. And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord,
God of power and might, heaven and earth
are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest. And holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. Your Spirit anointed him to preach good news to the poor, to proclaim release to the captives, a recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who were oppressed, and to announce that the time had come when you would save your people. He healed the sick, fed the hungry, and ate with the sinners. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. When the Lord Jesus ascended, he promised to be with us always, in the power of your word and Holy Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took the bread, gave thanks to you, and broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take it. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave it thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood, my covenant, poured for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink in remembrance." And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice, in union with Christ's offering for us, as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
And pour out your Holy Spirit on us, gathered here. And on this gift of bread and wine, make it before us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in the final victory, and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the Holy Church, all honor and glory to yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
This time, I invite you to come forward and receive Jesus' body and blood given to you. This body and little question here for you. us pray. Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we may go into the world in the strength of your Spirit to give ourselves for others. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And this is a special anthem time. So this time Danny and Jen and myself will sing. But then what's our stage song? It's a kind of a new song and contemporary music, so some of you may not familiar with this song song. I hope you enjoy and we can praise God together. It's a new song.
Amen.
Right?
And this is time for offering a gift and tithe. And I invite you to stand as we sing together the blessing.
Thank you.
Till we meet.